c'est la première étape-là. Absolutely. So, let us recite together, inshallah, as part of our khatam, and also double intention, inshallah. So khatam, and likewise, collection of recitation. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Together, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
رحيم
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 so the rules don't change whether we it's any setting number 97 قل من كان عدوا لجبريل فإنه نزله على قلبك بإذن الله what is it 97 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
together ان شاء الله قل من كان عدوا لجبريل فإنه نزله على قلبك بإذن الله مصدقا مصدقا لما بين يديه وهدى وبشرى للمؤمنين من كان عدوا لله وملائكته ورسله وجبريل وميكال فإن الله عدو للكافرين ولقد أنزلنا إليك آيات بينات وما يكفر بها إلا الفاسقون أوكلما عاهدوا عهدا نبذه فريق منهم بل أكثرهم لا يؤمنون ولما جاءهم رسول من عند الله مصدق لما معهم نبذ فريق من الذين أوتوا الكتاب كتاب الله وراء ظهورهم كأنهم لا يعلمون So very quickly, last week we discussed the hills and the greed, the constant desire of the Yahud and likewise Alladhina Ashraku, those the polytheists and the disbelievers, the idolaters in their desire for living for eternity. And Allah says, you will find them that they are most desirous and clinging to life. More eagerly than anyone else. أحرص الناس يعني أحرص most amongst mankind greedy for life. And then Allah says يود أحدهم لو يعمر ألف سنة they would desire to live for 1,000 years they even more than that. وما هو بمزحزحه من العذاب أن يعمر. But Allah says and reminds again they prolonged living if it was given to them will not deter them or keep them away from the fire. They will still be subjected to the fire if the punishment is this time for them. Wallahu basirun bima ya'malun. Today's lesson Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is discussing the adawa and the enmity that the Yahud had for Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salatu wa taslimat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Whoever is the enemy of Jibreel or the angel Gabriel should know فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ should know that he revealed this Quran to your heart by Allah's will. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقَ confirming what came before it. وَهُدًى وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ and a guide and good news for the believers. مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوَ لِلَّهِ The next ayah, and whoever is the enemy of Allah Ta'ala, and not only Allah, but together with Allah is the enemy of the angels of Allah, جبرائيل ميكائيل إسرافيل عزرائيل وأبيتيز ورسله and any of the prophets of Allah سبحانه وتعالى whether it's محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عيسى عليه السلام موسى عليه السلام يوسف عليه السلام إبراهيم عليه السلام نوح عليه السلام any of the prophets okay so the يهود they had enmity with سيدنا عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام and they came to have killed him أعوذ بالله and of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم as well they attempted his assassination وجبريل Allah says and whoever has enmity with جبرائيل specifically Allah talks of So Allah may mention وملائكته his angels and then exclusively Allah says and جبرائيل and ميكائيل فإن الله عدو للكافرين then let them know that Allah is certainly the enemy of the disbelievers. So this is an act of kufr when a person has enmity for any of the above that means he would consider or not believe in them hence the enmity. So this is an act of kufr. إن الله عدو للكافرين. Imam al-Fadl rahmatullah alayhi says, أجمع أهل العلم بالتأويل جميعا. The أهل العلم, the scholars of Deen, مفسرين exegetes of Quran and Hadith, and they have of consensus that this ayah was revealed جوابا لليهود من بني إسرائيل as an answer to the Yahud from the Bani Israel. Why is that? إذ زعموا إذ زعموا أن جبرائيل عدو لهم وأن ميكائيل ولي لهم. They claimed that جبرائيل was the enemy and ميكائيل was the friend. سبحان الله. جبرائيل was the enemy, ميكائيل was the friend. إمام البخاري رحمه الله says under the ayat من كان عدو لجبرائيل لجبريل أو ميكائيل من كان عدو لجبريل فإنه نزله. He says قال يخرم جبر And the word Meek, yani Mikael, all of these names, Jibrail, Mikael, Israfil, Israf. So as we said before, under the name of Israel, Israel was translated as, anybody remembers? Israel, Bani Israel. Yaqub al-Islam. Yaqub al-Islam, what's the literal meaning of Israel? Was Abdullah. Abdullah. So Isra was Abd and Il is Allah. Il is Allah. So in the names of the angels as well, you got Jibra'il, or you got Mika'il, or you got Israfil, so understand? No, Azra'il. So Il, as in Allah, and the preceding names, Jibr, Mik, and Israf, these all mean Abd, as in slave. So Jibra'il, servant of Allah, Abdullah, servant of Allah. Similarly, Mikael, similarly, Israfil, different names. But all mean the same thing. Abdullah, servant, slave of Allah. Servant, slave of Allah. So as a reference to this ayah, Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he heard of the coming of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. He came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he asked him some certain questions. إني سائلك عن ثلاث لا يعلمهن إلا نبي. I'll ask you three questions that no one knows besides a Nabi. The answer of it no one knows besides a Nabi. And he asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أول أشراط الساعة. What is the first of the signs of the hour? وما أول طعام أهل الجنة. What is the first food of the people of Jannah? وما ينزع الولد إلى أبيه أو إلى أمه. And what pulls a child to take the gender of his father or his mother? And how does the child become either male or a female? What is the sort of the chemical reaction that takes place in the womb that a child will become either male or a female? قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said أخبرني بهن جبريل آنفا. On that, just before we continue, you may have noticed. In the ayah is written, "من كان عدوا لجبريل لجبريل," and we know it as جبرائيل. صحيح. Similarly, and ورسله وجبريل وميكال وميكال. So these are all different قراءات, different recitations of the same word. It could be recited as جبرائيل جبريل It could be recited as Mikail. It could be recited as Mikal. It could be recited as Mikaila without the ya. These are all different recitations of the same word, and they come, they appear in different qira'at from the qira'at that we have. So Rasulullah SAW said to him, the akhbarani bi inna Jibreel anifa. Jibreel just brought the information of the question which you asked right now. He said, فَقَرَأَ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا قَالَ جِبْرَئِيلُ قَالَ نَعَمْ قَالَ So Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu anhu said, Jibreel brought the information? He said, yes. The Messenger of Allah said, yes. قَالَ ذَلِكَ عَدُوُ الْيَهُودِ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ That is the enemy of the Yahud from the angels. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ سبحان الله. And then the hadith continues, the shahid, the reference of the hadith is what we just talked of now. Then Jibreel came with the information. He then said to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that this Jibreel is the enemy of the Yahud. And then Allah Ta'ala revealed the verses, مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu anhu obviously took shahada in that same majlis, and the discussion continues. It's a rather beautiful hadith, because sometime inshallah we should read the hadith.
Is it reference? Hadith reference?
Bukhari. As we mentioned earlier on as well, just to reiterate, the word il refers to Allah. And the other nouns that precede it, which is a noun of possession, is means abd, the servant of Allah Ta'ala. Servant of Allah. So it will be Abdullah, Abdul Rahman, Abdul Jalil, Abdul Salam, Abdul Kafi, like that. In Arabic, it will be the other way around. In Arabic here, it's the other way around. In other languages, it's swapped around. The mudaf and the mudaf ilayh. Anyway. Whoever seeks to create differences between the Anbiya, between the Malaika as well, is an act of kufr, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outlines in ayah. Inna alladhina yakfuruna billahi wa rusulihi wa yuriduna an yufarriqu bayna Allahi wa rusulihi ويقولون نؤمن ببعض ونكفر ببعض ويريدون أن يتخذوا بين ذلك سبيلا. They don't want to believe only, and they don't disbelieve only, but they seek to a road in between. They say, no, we believe in some, we disbelieve in the others, we accept this one, we don't accept that one. They're making tafriq. So tafriq, whether it's regarding the anbiya, whether it's regarding the malaika, is an act of kufr. من كان عدوا لله. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reminds whomsoever chooses enmity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the angels of Allah, or the prophets of Allah ta'ala, and specifically Allah ta'ala talks about Jibreel and Mikael, because in specific reference to Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, because they have claimed that he is their enemy. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala classifies that Allah is now the enemy of such a person. The hadith goes, that person, من عادى لي وليا. من عادى لي وليا. Subhanallah, Bukhari, عن أبي هريرة. Bukhari, from the hadith of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه, Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من عادى لي وليا فقد بارزني بالحرب. That person who wages enmity with any of my friends. So the Anbiya, the friends of Allah Ta'ala, the Malaika, the pious servants, the Salihin, these are the friends of Allah Ta'ala, Anyone who has enmity with the friend of Allah, قَدْ غَارَزَنِي بِالْحَرْبِ, he has, that person has now announced war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The words of another riwayah, same, عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ آذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. Whoever has enmity with any wali and friend of mine, قَدْ آذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. And this is an announcement of war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On two occasions we learn that there is war with Allah. One is this occasion here, and the other is, which is in the Quran al-Kareem, and that is regarding the consumption of riba and interest. Moving on to the next verse. وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ وَمَا يَكْفُرُ بِهَا إِلَّا الْفَاسِقُونَ. And obviously we have sent to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam the clear revelations and the clear signs. Okay. Yani there are clear signs that indicate the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the finality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا يَكْفُرُ بِهَا إِلَّا الْفَاسِقُونَ. And only none will deny and reject the signs of Allah ta'ala except the rebellious. The signs are too many to make mention in terms of the knowledge that Rasulullah brought to the people, the information which no one knew besides a Nabi would know. For example, the one we just gave above, the stories of the people of the past whom the Arabs had no knowledge about, etc., etc. So these ayat are recited in the Quran al-Kareem, are replete in the Quran al-Kareem. There are physical signs, there are other signs, all different signs. وَمَا يَكْفُرُ بِهَا إِلَّا الْفَاسِقُونَ. أَوَكُلَّمَا عَاهَدُوا عَهْدًا نَبَذَهُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Why is it that every time they make a covenant with Allah Ta'ala, and this is the ada, this is the habit of the Yahud, that every time they make a pledge, every time they have a treaty, every time they have an agreement, they break that agreement. أَوَكُلَّمَا عَاهَدُوا عَهْدًا نَبَذَهُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ. One group of them, or a sect of them, or amongst them, a large number of people will go and break and cast aside. To cast aside. Why is it that every time they make a covenant, a group of them cast the covenant aside? In fact, most of them do not believe. Most of them do not believe. قال مالك بن سيف حين بعث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent, وَذَكَّرَهُمْ مَا أُخِذَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ مِثَاقٍ, and reminded them of the covenant and pledges they took with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا عَاهِدَ إِلَيْهِمْ فِي مُحَمَّدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the covenant that Allah took with them in the Torah regarding the coming of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the نبي آخر الزمان, and his name was mentioned to them as Ahmad. اسمه Ahmad. In the Torah his name was mentioned as Ahmad. What did they say? They said, Wallahi ma ahida ilayna fi Muhammad. There's no, Allah has not taken any covenant with us regarding Muhammad. Who is this? We don't know him. As we have done earlier on, when the Prophet ﷺ came and he turned out to be not from the Bani Israel, but from Bani Ismail, oh, their worst nightmare. He's not of us, he's not of our time. So this was the point of differentiation. The enmity became vile at this particular point, and they chose to disbelieve. They said, no, we don't know who this Muhammad is. We don't know. That's a different person that's discussed. فَأَنْذَرَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. So Allah revealed the verse, أَوَكُلَّمَا عَاهَدُوا عَهْدًا. So why is it when every time Allah takes a pledge, they take a pledge, then a group of them chooses to cast it aside? SubhanAllah. حسن البصري رحمه الله عليه said regarding من أكثرهم لا يؤمنون قال نعم. He said yes. ليس في الأرض عهد يعاهدون عليه إلا نقضوه ونبذوه. There is no عهد, there is no pledge that they take on this earth except that they will sever it, they will break it, they will cast it aside. وَعَاهِدُونَ الْيَوْمِ وَيَنْخُضُونَ غَدًا. Today they make a pledge, tomorrow they break the pledge. Today they have a ceasefire, the next day, 2-3 days down the line, they break the ceasefire. So you can go on signing peace treaties till the day of judgment. The habit of these people will not change. The habit of these people will not change, will remain the same. They did it with Allah, they did it with Allah's messengers. They would kill up to 300 Anbiya in one day. It came earlier on. Up to 300 Anbiya in one day, and then in the afternoon they would go and go in the marketplaces and continue in the trade and commerce. Yani, can you imagine the mindset of the and the heart of this people, heartless people? That you kill 300 of Allah's chosen servants, the Anbiya, who come to you with the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one day, and then towards the end of the day, in the afternoon, go and set up your marketplace, go do your buying and selling. Don't blink an eyelid. Don't blink an eyelid, subhanAllah. So, they go do such an act like that, breaking a pledge, denying and rejecting Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam being mentioned in the Torah, something small for them. One stage further. وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. And when the Prophet, when the Messenger of Allah came to them, has come to them from Allah Ta'ala, مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ, verifying and confirming what is in their own scriptures. So, continuously you would hear this regarding the Quran and the message of the Quran, that the message of the Quran is not something different from the messages of the scriptures before. It is a confirmation of what has already come. The only difference is now, there's an addition of one last prophet. The only difference is now, is a slight change in the legislation. The only difference is now, you chose to observe a Saturday as the day of worship, and Allah said, no, the day of your worship is Friday, not Saturday, not Sunday. It's the only difference. So there are minor differences in the legislation, in the order of the day, which will last you until the day of judgment, so that you can worship for the first generation of Muslims, and the last generation of Muslims will be able to practice the same deen and the same sharia, and will not be difficult on either sides of anyone. So you can be living in the highest level of opulence and luxury and technology, and you will be living as a believer Muslim following the sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you could be living in the first era, in the golden era, at the time of Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and you're following the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is how Allah designed this new Sharia for us. That the message of the Quran, the core message of the Quran, came as confirmation of what was before already. What was before? Tawheed of Allah, Risalat of the Prophet and the Prophet of the Prophets, an addition of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Anbiya is there, Qiyamah is there, Yawm al-Akhir is there, the last day is there, Jannah is there, Jahannam is there, Hisab and Kitab is accountability is there, the bridge of Sirat is there, everything is there. As Rasulullah Sassam said, we are like one tree and there's different branches. Nabi Nuh, Nabi Hud, Nabi Salih, Nabi Rahim, Nabi Musa, Nabi Isa, all different, but the branch is one, the tree is one. وَلَمَّا جَاءَ الرَّسُولُ مِنْ لِلَّهِ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُ نَبَذَ فَرِيقٌ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ. They were a group of the people who were given the Torah. They even chucked the Torah aside. Why? Because now, when the عَرَضُوهُ بِالْتَوْرَةِ فَلَمَّا جَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَرَضُوا بِالْتَوْرَةِ فَخَاصَمُوا بِهَا. They compared the Torah up to the Quran, or the Quran up to the Torah. فَاتَّفَقَتِ التَّوْرَةُ وَالْقُرْآنُ. And naturally, the Torah and the Quran are in conformity with one another. Because it's the word of Allah, and the Quran gave its confirmation of the Torah. So, أَوَلَمَا جَاءَهُمْ كِتَابٌ مِنْ رَسُولٍ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ. And then they did the comparison, and they wanted to confirm the message of the Quran, so they compared it to the Torah, and they found that the Torah and the Quran is similar. نبذ فريق من الذين أوتوا الكتاب كتاب الله وراء ظهورهم. They took the same Torah which they believed in and they even chucked it aside. سبحان الله. فنبذوا التوراة and then what they did? واتخذوا بكتاب آسف وسحر وسحر هاروت وماروت. And then they turned towards جعلوا and black magic. Because now obviously the message of the book in the books of black magic and جعلوا and all these things is not going to match up with the message of the Quran and neither the Torah. So because they will sell themselves and they'll sell their families, because the Quran is in confirmation and comparing it to the Torah is equal, it's the same thing, same message. So check both aside. Because inside they don't know what to believe. Inside they don't know what to do. They just check the Torah, check the Quran, check everything inside. And then they turn towards Jadu and Sihar, which is going to come next week lesson, inshallah. كأنهم لا يعلمون, as if they don't know. As if they don't know. They turn their backs, they threw the book of Allah behind their backs, as if they did not know. SubhanAllah. إن القوم كانوا يعلمون ولكنهم نبذوا علمهم وكتموا وجحدوا به. SubhanAllah. InshaAllah, we'll stop at that point and then we'll continue next week. It's an interesting discussion, the discussion of Harut and Marut and around the issue of black magic and how the whole thing came about, whatever, inshaAllah. So that discussion for next week, Allah Ta'ala grants us tawfiq. Subhanallah, bihamdihi, subhanallah, wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.